Do you want to know how to add an extra product tab to your product page in your WooCommerce store so you can add more details about your products?
Hi guys, this is Bully. Today I am going to show you guys how to add a custom product tab on a product page to your WooCommerce WordPress website. All right, let's begin.
All right, WooCommerce comes with three default standard tabs. The first one is description, the next one is additional information, and the third one is reveals. We're gonna use a free plugin to add an extra custom product tab, so we'll have more tabs to use. By using a free plugin that is called Custom Product Tabs for WooCommerce by Yite. And first, we are going to add a custom tab to each product page. And the second one, we are going to add multiple saved custom tabs to add to each product page. Let's go with the first one. First, let's add a custom tab to each product page. All right, let's go to our demo store. Click plugins or click add new. If you come to this page, go to the top of the page to click add new, and then go to the search box onto your right to type custom product tabs for WooCommerce. That's the plugin that we are going to install. I don't see the install now button because I installed this plugin earlier, so just click the install now and then click the activate button. There are a couple of links the plugin provides that you could click to see more information, but I am going to show you how to use the saved tab link feature near the end of this video. So let's click products right here on the left panel. Click a product, whatever the product you want to add an extra custom tab. I am gonna pick this t-shirt. Scroll down a little bit to the product data section right here. The last tab or the last link is the custom tabs. Just click it and then click the button add a tab. Enter a tab title right here. Enter description in your description box. In this case, I am going to add the size information right here. I wanted to move the information from the description tab to its own tab. Next, just click the add a tab to add another tab if you want to. Let's add interesting facts here, whatever you want to add, and just add a dummy text here for a demo only. And let's add another tab just for a test. And click the save tabs. Don't forget to scroll up to click the update button. Let's go to the front end to see the changes. Click the refresh button. Here they are. There are three of them right here. Okay, they're all working fine. Let's go back to the back end again. Go back to the custom tabs. If you find this video helpful, please consider subscribing to my channel. I always appreciate your support. This is how you can remove each tab. Just click the red button right there to remove the tab, and then it will be gone. And as you can see here, there are vertical angle icons used for ordering tabs up and down. So just click the save tabs once everything looks good and click the update button. Let's go back to the front end again to refresh it. Let's see. There you go. The test tab is gone. We have only two left as of right now. That's how you remove a tab. All right, let's go back to the dashboard again because I want to order the tabs. I want the tab size to come first. All right, let's update it here. Let's go back to the front end to see the results. And here it is. I got the size tab starting first. All right, next, I am gonna show you how to add multiple saved custom tabs to add to each product page. All right, let's go back to the plugins page this time. Scroll down to the plugin. You'll see the link called Saved Tabs. Click the link. Actually, you also can click the menu on the left panel right there. Click Add New and add a tab title right here. Next, enter the tab name. It's just for your reference only. And then enter the tab content right there. Once everything looks good, just click the Save Tab button at the bottom of the box. Click Go Back to All Saved Tabs list at the top of the page to check if the tab we entered previously will be there. Yes, it is there. You could click all these links to edit the tab or delete the tab, or the Edit the Tab button right there is working too. Let's click Add New again to add another tab. Enter the tab title, the tab name, and the tab content. Once everything looks good, just click the Save tab. Let's click on that link to go back to all the tabs list. Here you go, we got two of them so far. So how are we gonna use them? Alright, let's go back to the products page again. Let's pick the t-shirt product again for a demo. And scroll down to the custom tabs link right here. So we're gonna use this button instead. And then here it is. You could see all the tabs that we just created earlier. Just click the plus sign on the right of the tab you wanna add. Right here, we're not gonna be able to edit the tab title at all, but we will be able to edit the tab content right here. But don't forget to check that box to override the save tab content. Once everything looks good, just click the save tabs right there and scroll up to click the update button of your product page. Let's go back to the front end to see the result or see the changes. Refresh the page. Here it is. The words tab is right there. And that's the new gibberish word that I just added to override the original content. Alright, you guys have the most wonderful day wherever you are. I will see you in my next video. Bye!